master the SUMIF function in Excel. I'll show you how to use it to add up values in a range based on a specific condition with a single click. Just like this. Imagine you work at Apple and need to analyze the sales from the Fifth Avenue store to compare its performance with other flagship locations. You've got this list that shows the month of every sale, the store, the product, and how much money it made. But man, if you try to add up the sales from that one store one by one, you'd be there forever. To speed things up, let's use the SUMIF function. But before we get to that, I've got a little trick that will make this function 1,000 times easier. We're gonna define range names. If you're wondering what that means, it's simply a way to assign a name to a group of cells, making it easier to reference them in your formulas. Simply select the range and up here in the name box, type in the name you want to use. For instance, we'll name this range month. While you're at it, define the range names for store. Product. Sales. And units. One key thing to remember is to hit enter after typing in the name box. Otherwise, Excel won't save the name. Now, on to the SUMIF function. Start by typing equals SUMIF to open up your formula. This friendly function only asks for three things. First, it'll ask you for the range. This is crucial. It's not yet asking you for the range you want to sum up. It's asking for the range you want to evaluate with a condition. In this case, you want to evaluate the store name, right? This is where your range names come in handy. Instead of selecting from B1 to B271, just type in store. Voila, it selected the store range for you. Much smoother and quicker, don't you think? Next, it'll ask you for the criteria, the condition that needs to be met. In this case, you're only interested in the Fifth Avenue store, so select the cell with the store name. Before we continue, if you haven't already, hit the subscribe button because every week I'm going to be giving away a complete Excel course valued at $297 randomly to 10 of my subscribers. Now, let's continue. The third request from our function is the range you want to sum up. The sales, so type in sales. Hit enter and boom. No need for filters, no manual calculations, just one formula. What happens if you swap this store with Cupertino? It updates all by itself. You now have a 100% dynamic and reusable formula. If you want to visually see the percentage each store contributed to the total, you could create a pie chart. But that's a magic trick for another video, which I'll link up here. See you there!